So in this video, you're going to learn how to create your own AI chatbot using your own content and training it on that content, and then Ask AI will create a chatbot that users can ask questions and it will respond using the information that you have given it. So it's a really, really cool tool, and I'm going to show you how to use it. So you're going to want to go to myaskai.com, and we're just going to go ahead and create an account, and we're going to use their free account version, so you don't have to pay to try it out. So we're going to go to create an account and just go ahead and enter your email or connect with Google, and then we will meet in the dashboard page. All right, so here we are on the dashboard page, and I'm just going to go ahead and enter in this information. Your onboarding could be a little bit different if Ask AI has changed it since I created this video. But here we are, and we're going to create our first Ask AI now. So we're going to give it a name, and what I'm going to do is create a chatbot that is going to, I'm going to feed it in information from a Tim Ferriss podcast. So this is going to be a Tim Ferriss podcast episode. And then create Ask AI. And now it's going to say, how do you want to use it? Chat, explain, or search. And as you can see, chat is more of a short conversational chatbot. Explain is going to give you a much longer response. And search is just going to give you links for people to go and do their own research. I'm going to do a chat and save and continue. And now what it's going to say is add your content for our Ask AI. And in the free version, you can upload 3 pieces of content. You can pay and add more if you'd like. And here you can either add a file of information or you can just add a website. So in our case, we're going to want to add a website which contains the transcript of the podcast. So to do this, you could just search Tim Ferriss podcast transcripts, and you'll get to this page here, which is going to have a link to every single transcript from Tim's podcast show. So if we go down, I'm just going to pick one. Why don't I go and search for Andrew Huberman? I'll copy the link there and go to it, and then go to the top and copy the link. Now if I go back to my Ask AI and I add a website, I'm going to add one link here. It looks like it's cool. You can add 10 links or an entire website. In our case, I'm just going to add one link. Click and paste the link below and check it. And it's just going to load real quick. And here we go. So here is the link that we added. And this is kind of the reference for the source. So when the chatbot gives a response based on the contents of the podcast, it will say it's from this transcript, which is really helpful if you have multiple links. So let's say you put, you know, every episode of Tim Ferriss on here, it'll tell you which episode it's referring to when it responds. And I'm just going to say add to Ask AI, and now it's going to add it. So it's going to load real quick. Okay, cool. So it's added. And now all I have to do is click launch Ask AI. So you can add more content if you'd like, but here I'm just going to say launch. And there we go. So now you have your own chatbot here that you can use by sharing a link, customizing the settings. You can embed it on other sites if you want as well. If we go into the settings, you can see there's also the ability to kind of customize the look and feel, or kind of the way it's going to respond to questions if it doesn't know the answer, just as an example. So I'm going to go ahead and click save. There's analytics as well. But here we go. So it's going to say, hi there, how can I help you? And what's cool is also, based on the contents of the link that we shared, it's already asking questions, kind of default questions, which you can customize, I believe, here in the settings as well. You can uncheck show suggested questions if you'd like. So I'm going to click save. And let's just ask the first one. What has Andrew Huberman contributed to the field of neuroscience? And it's going to load and should give us a response in a second. So here we go. here is the response, and it's cool because it's going to give us the link here. So I could even say, what are some tips for improved sleeping? So I know this is something that was probably discussed on the podcast. Okay, awesome. So here we go. It's giving us a response here, according to Andrew Huberman, of what he says in the podcast. And also a really cool feature here is you can ask it, if you ask it a question that it doesn't know the answer to, it will tell you. So here I asked it, do you know what personal finance tips I should use to build my credit? This was not something discussed in the podcast episode that we uploaded here to our chatbot. So it's going to say, I'm sorry, I don't know the answer to that question. Please rephrase the question. Okay, cool. So I hope that you found this helpful of understanding how easy it is using MyAsk AI to create your own AI chatbot. I think this is really cool for a lot of different types of use cases. It's a really, really cool no-code tool. If you want to learn even more about building apps with AI and build your own complex apps that integrate with AI APIs, such as Stable Diffusion and OpenAI, and kind of build more complex use cases that you might have a business idea for, check out our course on No-Code MBA called Building Apps with AI. The link will be in the description. And we go into a lot more detail about how to build an AI writer with GPT-3, building an AI chatbot, building an image generation app, using fine-tuning an AI avatar generator with Dreambooth. So there's a lot of content here to really bring you up to speed with all of the latest AI APIs and connecting it to Bubble, which is a no-code tool that allows you to build these apps without writing a single line of code. The course is really great for beginners who are just starting out building their own apps or their own AI integration. So if you're interested, you can check out the link in the bio. And if you have any other questions about building apps with AI, please just leave a comment and I'll do my best to help you out.